Good morning. Well, let me tell you, the finance bill this time, I have not criticized the finance bill of the last 5 years. There was a reason for that. The gentleman, the finance minister, happened to be my student. How can he criticize the budget in that case? This year is not there. I have a full right to criticize till it is passed. Till it is passed. We have to give post-budget memorandum, and we are trying to give a lot of post-budget memorandum because I'm not very happy this time with the finance bill. So many changes. We had given the income tax bill way back on the 18th of August. It should have come there, but there are certain reasons I can't mention to you. But they have cherry-picked certain items from there against the SSC and not favorable to the SSC, which should not have been done in solo. But whatever is done, let me talk to you clause by clause what has happened in the income tax, this amendments in the direct taxes. There is a clause, section 2, clause 13A, talks about the business trusts. We have two kinds of business trust. One is called REIT, that is Real Estate Investment Trust. The another is called INVIT, that is the Infrastructure Investment Trust. These two trusts are getting a lot of benefit and advantages under the Income Tax Act because it is a pass-through entity. We invest in the units of these trusts and they in turn invest in the infrastructure or they invest in the real estate. But there was a requirement under the business trust, and the requirement was they were supposed to get their share listed on a recognized stock exchange. Unless and until their units, sorry, not share, unit. Unless and until their units are listed on a recognized stock exchange, they were not getting the benefit of this. Many approached us, what about those REIT and INVIT, those whose units are not listed? They are not getting benefit of that. So the law has now amended the definition, saying that the word they are required to get their unit listed on recognized stock exchange are hereby deleted, meaning thereby now the units are listed or they are not listed. It does not make any difference, though REIT and INVIT will get all the benefits which are there for business trusts. This was a small thing. Coming to now, section 242A, segregated units. We have a units called units where the money has been invested in the debt fund and the money has been invested in the money market fund. Money market is a shorter period, debt is a longer period. What happened is there was a demand that these should be bifurcated. These should be bifurcated. Now, they have been segregated into two parts, and while segregating into two parts, the period of holding of the units were supposed to be known. They have said the period of holding will be the original unit. And they have also said the cost of acquisition shall be apportioned between in a certain manner. I'm coming to now very important. Please try to listen this point. On 1st of February, when the bill came, there was a webinar by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. I was also one of them as a speaker. What really happened is, during that time, we got about 400 queries from UAE and many other countries. And also, many phone calls from there. What have you done? Particularly, the finger was at me that you had drafted the income tax bill. What have you done? This is not done. I said, wait and watch. Wait and no, no, sir. We are in a fix. I said, wait. I went to, of course, Dubai. I went to Kuwait also, went to Qatar also, went to Oman also recently and told them what has happened. Let me explain to you. In our country, the Indians have taken away the money from this country. Indians, I'm talking about citizens of India. They have taken away the money from this country by good means or by dubious means and taken that money and invested and settled at a place where there is no tax. like Cayman Island, like Bermuda, like they have invested the money, taken the money from where? From India. Earlier, Britisher used to take away the money. Now the Indians have taken away the money, maybe by good means or maybe by dubious means, and invested there, let's say in Cayman Island. There is no tax in Cayman Island. They are neither paying income tax on that income in India, nor they are paying income tax in that country because there is no tax there. Recently, you must have read, the government appointed me through this approval of the Supreme Court on the board of Unitech. What have they done? 4,300 crores was given as a loan to the subsidiary of the Unitech in Cayman Island. And thereafter, they have written off that amount. Whose money was that, 4,300 crores? It was the money of the home buyers, it was the money of the banks, which has been taken to a country outside India and written off. What kind of a thing is this? That you are taking away the money from the country, it's country money, the income should be taxed in India, but you are not paying tax in India. Again, wrongly or rightly, I was appointed on the board of Ruchi Soya by Mr. Ramdev, Baba Ramdev had taken over. Now what really happened in there also? 7,000 crore bogus bills were raised and the money was transferred to country outside India. Whose money? It's a banker's money. It is our money. Even yesterday you have seen Yes Bank, what has happened. Whose money is this? It is our money. And what are you doing? Giving to DHFL, giving to this place. They have done money laundering and taken the country outside India. We told them, look here, 4 years back, in United States, USA, came out with a law, USA. What was the law in USA? The USA said, whosoever is the citizen of USA or who holds green card of USA shall be deemed to be resident of the USA. Shall be deemed to be resident of the USA even if he does not stay in USA for one day. He will be deemed to be, meaning thereby, once you are resident of the country, you are supposed to pay tax on the global income. Global income means not only the income which they are earning in US, but also the income which they were earning in a country outside India. Look here, it is US money. You are taking the US money to the foreign places. You are taking to the place where you are not paying tax. It is a global problem. Look here, you will be resident. And once you are resident, you are supposed to pay tax on the global income. This is what happened. Apple, you talk about Apple telephones. Apple had a very small establishment in US. And they have shifted into Ireland and making a lot of money there in Ireland. Apple was told, look here, come back to US. We'll give you concession, but we will not tolerate such type of a thing that you are having. We call this BEPS, base erosion, profit shifting. You are shifting the profit to a country where there is no tax, or to a country where there is very small amount, minimum type of a tax. It cannot be done. Now we are not less than America. We are not less than USA, I'm telling you. What we have done. Listen to me what we have done. There is Section 6, Clause 1. Under the Income Tax Act, now you will have to go back to the time when you were studying as a chartered accountant study. When an individual is said to be resident in India, the law is an individual is said to be resident in India if he has been in India for a period or period amounting to all 182 days in the relevant previous year. If you are in India for 182 days, you are resident. Or in the four preceding previous year, 365 days, and in the relevant previous year, 60 days or more. You are resident. And there are two explanations also. That person who leaves India for employment abroad period of 60 days will be substituted by 182 days. Or a citizen of India or a person of Indian origin who makes a visit to India, the period of 60 days will be taken. I'll talk about this later. Now, try to understand what is the amendment. Please try to understand. Section 6, Clause 1A has been inserted. And what is that clause? Please, what is that clause? Notwithstanding anything contained under section 6.1. You can know what is not withstand. Forget about 6.1. Forget about 182 days. Forget about 60 days. Not withstanding. What is given in 6.1? If an individual is a citizen of India, if he is a citizen of India, he shall be deemed to be a resident of India if he is not liable to pay tax in the foreign country due to his residence, due to his domicile, or criteria of similar nature. Look here. You are a citizen? Yes. You are resident of our country. If, when are you a resident, deemed resident? If you are not liable to pay tax in the foreign country due to your domicile, due to your residence, or criteria of similar nature. You are in Cayman Island? Okay. Means you are not liable to pay tax there? Then you will be treated as deemed resident. And the moment you are deemed resident, you have to pay tax on the global income, that is income which you are earning in a country outside India. God calls from UAE, sir, we are in Dubai, we are in Abu Dhabi, there is no tax in Dubai or Abu Dhabi. We will be greatly affected because we have come from India, we are earning income there, we are sending the money to India, we are not the other way around. I said, wait, don't worry. Kuwait, again there is no tax. Oman, again there is no tax. Even Qatar, there is no income tax on that. They say we will all be affected. I said, wait here. I went there. I said, look here. Where are you there? You are in Dubai. Are you a resident of Dubai? He said, yes, sir, we are resident of Dubai. But you are saying that you are deemed resident of India. And the moment we are deemed resident of India, we will have to pay tax on the foreign income because we are not paying tax in Dubai. He said, wait. I said, we have a double taxation avoidance agreement with the UAE, with Kuwait, with Oman, with Qatar. What is that double taxation avoidance agreement? I said, what happens is, sometimes you are resident of both the countries, resident of UAE also, a resident of India also. I said, recently we won two matches from New Zealand under T20. What were those T20 matches? The match was tight. You can't be winner of both the both cannot be winner. We have to choose only one winner. So what we do? Don't say super over. Tiebreaker rule. The match was tight. Between us. The tiebreaker rule was play one super over. Whoever scores the most will be the winner. Play one. This is a tiebreaker rule. And if by chance both score the same amount, what will happen? Again one more over. Tiebreaker. Till finally it is decided who is the winner. I said, don't worry. You are resident of Dubai. You are resident of India because you are deemed a resident. Don't worry. There is a tie. Let us apply tiebreaker rule. He said, what is that? I said, you have never read, but we have read it. There is a tiebreaker rule. What is that tiebreaker rule? Rule one, that if you are a resident of both the countries, you will be resident of that country where you have permanent establishment. You have a permanent establishment in Dubai. Sir, we also have a permanent establishment in India. I said, don't worry. Again tie. Let us go for the second tiebreaker rule. What the second tiebreaker rule says, where you have a vital interest or economic interest. I said, where you have economic interest? Sir, in Dubai. I said, you are resident of Dubai, you will become non-resident of India. Don't worry. Sir, wait. We are senior. We have both vital interests in Dubai as well as in India. I said, don't worry. Again, tie. Let us go for the another tiebreaker rule. The another tiebreaker rule says, where you have habitual abode. Their habitual abode is Dubai. So, sir, Ashwani ji, they are resident in Dubai. And moment they are resident in Dubai, they will become non-resident in India. And once they are non-resident in India, they are not supposed to pay tax on the income which accrue or arise outside India. Oh, sir, great relief. Great relief. What a relief. But you have to be there, I said, for 183 days in Dubai. You may not come to India one day. You are deemed a resident, but doesn't make any difference. You are, due to tiebreaker rule, you will be a resident of that country. Only you will have to produce tax residency certificate. That is a big problem. Okay. Went to Kuwait, same rule. There is a treaty, tiebreaker rule. Went to Oman, same rule. Treaty, tiebreaker rule. And even, but there is one country, Bahrain, we don't have so far the treaty with them or double taxation. We went for it, but we thought there is no tax, why should we go for treaty? We may enter into a treaty by 31st March, or we may give them some concession through the notification or the circular, wait and watch. They will not be affected. But those who are in Cayman Island, those who are in Bermuda, those who are in Bahama, those who are in the country which are tax haven country, we do not have double taxation agreement with them. We do not have double taxation agreement with them. And therefore, you will be deemed to be resident in India. And the moment you are deemed to be resident in India, you will have to pay tax on the income which you are going to earn in that country, since you are not paying tax in that. What is the harm in it? Is it bad? It is correct. Borrowed money you are taking abroad, you are planning in such a manner that neither you pay tax in India nor you pay tax in a country outside India. And whose money? Our money. And sometimes you wave it off. Sometimes you say, so we are not going to allow you. And this is the law which has changed. You have introduced Section 6, Clause 1A by saying, look, if you are not liable to pay tax in that country, you will be deemed a resident. This is the first part of the story. Now there is a second part of the story, not related with this. There are people, most of the Indians, high net worth people, have become non-resident of this country. Intentionally, they have become non-resident. They have taken away the money by money laundering. They have taken the money by any method. They are keeping the money in Swiss bank. They are taking the money in Panama. They are taking the money outside India. And most of them become resident of Singapore. Because in Singapore, the rate of tax is 15%. Whereas in our country, the rate of tax is 30%. Not only 30%, the bimari is the surcharge 37%. Because they are rich people, more than 5 crore, they have to pay surcharge of 37% and also education says amounting to 42.74%. Look here. We had a law. Think of a case, Swaraj Paul, way back in 70s, left India for settling in UK. He went from here. He said, I will also earn money in UK. Early 70s. Mrs. Gandhi was the Prime Minister at that time. She was taken as the sister of Swaraj Paul. We call it Rakhi sister or Rakhi brother. Swaraj Paul talked to Mrs. Gandhi, look here, I have my roots in India. I'm a citizen of India. Okay, I have come to UK to earn money. But I have my roots there. I would love to come to India, do business there also. I would love to come to India, do business there also, and you take tax on that, whatever I earn in India, but don't take any tax whatever I earn in UK. But I can't stay here for more than 59 days, because even the four preceding previous year, I was here for 365 days. The moment I'm here for 60 days, I become resident. And the moment I become resident, I have to pay tax. Either pay tax in India. She gladly increased that limit from 60 days to 90 days. That means he could come and stay in India for 89 days. Clear? Then 90 days was raised to 150 days. And ultimately, 150 days were raised to 182 days. Saying that you are citizen of India, You are a person of Indian origin. You have roots in India. Please come to India. Bring money to India. Use this money in India. Pay tax here on the money which you are earning in India at a lower rate, under treaty. And you will get the credit of that tax in the foreign country because of double taxation avoidance agreement. But come to India and invest in India. We wanted this because you are our citizen. You are our person of Indian origin. You have a roots here. We want you to come to India and do business here. Those were different days. Now people are taking away the money from India and settling abroad where there is taxes lower rate. Many people have gone from here. Practically every rich man is trying to become non-resident. Why is becoming non-resident? Try to understand. We brought Black Money Foreign Undisclosed Income Act in 2015. Yes, sir, 2015. He happens to be the member of the ITAT, retired from there. Mr. Ashwini Taneja is also from Delhi. He will be talking to you, of course, by Benami law and money laundering. I'm approaching into that. Please try to understand what I'm saying. Look here. If you are a resident, an ordinary resident in India, you have to state in your return of income the details of all the foreign assets and your financial interest in a country outside India and also your beneficial interest in a country outside India. And also, if you are signing anything, you have to give detail in your return of income. Am I right? When you are a resident, you have to give detail. They don't want to give detail. We had given them a concession. We had given them an amnesty in 2015. Bring your money from the foreign country. Declare that money here. Pay tax. We will not tax you anything. We will not say you anything. Pay only tax. We will not put you penalty or anything. But nothing came. Only 4,000 crore came. Tons of money is lying of Indians outside India. And now they don't want to become resident. The moment they become resident, they will have to declare details of the foreign asset. They will never declare the detail of the foreign asset. And if they do not declare fully, they will be behind the bar for a period of 10 years. Minimum 10 years. Prosecution. So they don't want to come to India. They want to stay outside India. They pay tax less there. Whose money you have taken? Our money. Now you are saying there is a corruption in India. My dear, you have taken only corruption money to a country outside India. You say there is a pollution in India. The pollution was because of you, not because of us, I tell you. Why are you saying that there is a pollution in India? There is a corruption in India. You have taken the corruption money outside India. Lalit Modi is outside India. Neeram Modi is outside India. Malaya is outside India. And many other have gone outside India. The reason is they don't want to declare their foreign assets. Okay, now you are taking money from here and investing in foreign establishment. Videocon started some factory there. SR Steel started many factories there. Even Tata has done. It's not that, but Tata is an honest person. But you are trying to take away the money by good means or by means. Even non-resident can take $1 million every year officially also. $1 million you can take every year officially under the liberalized scheme. What is this? That you are taking the money of this country and you are not paying tax in India, we don't want you along. So this period of 182 days has been brought down to 120 days. Person of citizen of India or person of Indian origin who makes a visit to India, the period of 182 days shall be reduced to 120. We recommended only 90 days. I said, why give them concession? They will never become resident of India. They are misusing the funds. And let us not give the benefit to them. If they are bringing money to India, it is a different thing. They are not bringing money to India. They are taking away the money from this country by money laundering. Yes, sir. By money laundering, by any other thing, hawala transactions, and everything they are doing it. We don't want them. It has been brought to 120. That means you can stay here only for 90s. Earlier, you could stay here for 181 days without being called resident of India. And if you are 182 days, you are again a resident of India. So they were only one day difference. They were enjoying the benefit, staying in this country and not paying tax on the foreign income. Now, 190 days. But there are certain genuine people also. So for that, we had to give concession. There are two types of resident. Again, go back to CA exam. There are two type of residents. One is called a resident and ordinarily resident in India. The another is called resident but ordinary resident. What is the difference between the two? The difference between the two is the scope of total income. If you are a resident and ordinary resident in India, the income which accrue or arise outside India shall also be taxable in India. But if you are not ordinary resident in India, income which accrue or arise outside India shall not be taxable in India unless it is from a business which is controlled from India or a profession which is set up in India. We are saying, look here, if you are not ordinary, we are not taxing your foreign income. We are not taxing your salary income. We are not taxing your house property income. We are also not taxing your business income. We'll be taxing only that business income which is earned from a business controlled from India or which is from a profession which is set up in India. But we will give you this concession. But we have section 6.6 talking about not ordinary resident. Two conditions were there. That you must be non-resident in 9 out of 10 previous years, immediately preceding the relevant previous. I can't help it. Classroom teaching has to be done here. Because this is, we are not doing this thing. You must be non-resident in 9 out of 10 previous years, immediately preceding the relevant previous year. And you should not be in India for more than 729 days in the 7 preceding previous year, immediately preceding the relevant previous year. The moment you are resident for 2 out of 10, you become ordinary resident provided you are in India for 730 days or more in the 7 preceding previous year. Both the conditions are supposed to be satisfied. Look here. Second condition goes, 729 days. Goes. What is the benefit we are giving? You can be non-resident in 7 out of 10 previous year. 7. Instead of 9 out of 10, 7 out of 10 previous years immediately preceding the relevant previous. Meaning thereby, even if you are resident for 3 out of 10, you will be called not ordinarily resident in India. Out of 10, 3. And moment you are not ordinary resident of India, we are not going to tax the income which accrue or arise outside India unless it is from a business which is controlled from India or a profession which is the concession we are giving. Or second concession, resident but not ordinary resident is not supposed to declare his foreign assets in India. It is only resident and ordinary resident to declare. So we have given you the concession. Look, be here, even for 3 out of 10, we will not ask you the detail of your foreign assets. Actually, they are not interested in giving the detail of their. This is the reason. That's why they are all become non-resident in India. They don't want to declare because they have lot of money lying outside India, which they have not declared during that Black Money Act. Had they declared, they would not have bought any problem. So this is the reason of bringing 120 days instead of 182 days. Tell me, what is the wrong this government has done? They have made two changes. One change, you don't pay tax there, deemed resident. Second change, you pay tax there, but still you enjoy the benefit. Why? BEPS, base erosion. You are trying to befool us, taking the money outside India, keeping the money, don't want to declare the asset which you have kept outside India. Don't come. We'll keep you only for 190 days. We don't want now. You are taking the money from here, investing there, and enjoying the life. Everyone has done like that, these big people now. They don't want to keep the money in India. Oh, very difficult to live in India. Very difficult to live in. It is very good to live in UK because in the evening they play cards. They enjoy life there. They have villas there. They have so many things there. Okay, our money, not your money. You have earned from India and taken there. Even 1,40,000 crore of the State Bank of money is lying outside India, taken by them. This is not done. So this is the law which we have changed under non-resident. I think you should not be unhappy about it. Anyone who says this is wrong. I'm right? Can I proceed now? Next point. People have been saying to me, everybody says, Mr. Modi, the Prime Minister, is always traveling abroad. He's never seen in India. He has been traveling abroad day in, day out. And somebody asked me, is he a resident of India or a non-resident of India? He asked me. I said, look here, wait a minute. Nobody travels so much out of this only enjoyment. He's doing a lot of work. This is a liaison he's creating with the foreign countries. He said, how come? I said, it's a liaison he's creating. Nobody knew India. Now everybody knows India now. Nobody knew India. Now everybody knows India, what kind of India is this? And we are going towards 5 trillion economy. How can we go to 5 trillion economy unless we have a confidence in the foreign country? He goes there. Look here, 370 was abolished. After how many years? Did any country speak? No Muslim country also spoke. One only. We don't bother about that country. Otherwise, what, who spoke? Nobody said anything. And everything very smoothly, this has been done, 370. Unnecessarily, the opposition and other people have created one more problem of Ram Janmabhoomi. He has not done anything. It's all Supreme Court. But has anything happened? Nothing has happened. So it was only a chaos created or a fear created by opposition. This will happen. This man could do both the things. Then somebody asked me, what was the hurry in bringing CAA? What was the hurry? I said, it is not bad. Nobody is going to throw anybody outside. No, it's all opposition creation. Nobody can leave. They have more right in India than you have all also have. A koi chance nahi. But why they have done it? I'll have to speak in Hindi, a very good example. And please try to understand. Granny, you know what is granny? Housewife. Housewife is cooking food. She makes vegetables first. He has made vegetables. Now she is making chapatis. Rotis and chapatis. Now she has made chapatis. She made large chapati. And then she switched off the gas. Then she suddenly realized that wo jo tawa abhi bhi garam hai. Chalo ek chapati aur sek lete hain. क्या फर्क पड़ेगा? बात समझ में आ रहा है अश्विनी जी? एक चपाती और सेक ली है. अब वो हो सकता है कच्ची रह गई हो सकता है ज्यादा पक गई हो, लेकिन चपाती सेकना गैस बचाना था और कोई इंटेंशन नहीं थी. मैं आपको बता दूं, दिस इज द रीजन. अरे मोदी जी ने 5 ट्रिलियन इकोनॉमी बनानी है. आपको पता नहीं सेक्शन 1023 FE क्या डाला है. See that. We have Abu Dhabi Investment Authority. Abu Dhabi has lot of money. They invest that money in foreign countries to earn money. Sheikh also came on 26 January for Abu Dhabi. We requested Abu Dhabi Investment Authority. They come through subsidiaries. Kindly invest the money in India. You invest here. If you give us loan, we'll exempt your interest. If you give us capital, we'll exempt the dividend. And if you sell those shares, we'll exempt the capital gains. We have told others also, non-resident external account is also exempt. Please bring money here. We also have sovereign wealth funds of various countries. India also has. But we invest other places, they invest other places. We have, all countries have sovereign wealth funds. We requested them also, come and invest in India. I'm coming out with the section now. Income of a specified person. I'll tell you what is specified person. In the nature of interest, or in the nature of dividend, or in the nature of capital gain, shall be exempt if the following conditions are satisfied. We have said your interest income, your dividend income, your capital gain will exempt if the following conditions are satisfied. First, who are specified persons? Two kinds. Subsidiaries of what you call Abu Dhabi Investment Authority. And second is, because wahan paisa sheikh ka hai, so that is investment authority. Second is sovereign wealth fund of the various country. Please bring the money. Invest on or before, first condition, invest that money in India on or before 31st March 2024. Two, the lock-in period of investment should be a minimum period of 3 years. You cannot take back for a period of 3 years. And third condition, that it should be invested in an infrastructure funds defined under section infrastructure facility, sorry, infrastructure facility defined under clause I or section 80IA or section 4 or any other which may be prescribed from time to time. Please bring and invest the money in infrastructure facility. Development of road, dam, bridges, power unit, airport, ports, solid waste management, all those infrastructure. Please invest the money here. If you give us loan, we'll exempt your interest. If you invest in share, we'll exempt your dividend. And if you transfer the share after 3 years or any time later, we'll give you exemption of capital gain. What is the harm he has done? Trillion of money will come and he wants to make this country a 5 trillion economy. How can you make a country 5 trillion economy unless you get the money from out? So this is what he has done. Then somebody said, sir, why this date of 31st March 2024? Why not 25? Why not 30? I said, what time is his time is expiring? 5 year period? 2024. If he wins again, he will extend it. If he doesn't win, he said, do whatever you like. I have not to bother about that. That's why the date is 31st March 24 and not 25. 25 appears to be nice. No question. 24. 24 is the expiry term of Mr. Modi if he doesn't come back. But if he comes back, again we'll be extended. So this is what he has done. This is due to the confidence he has built in the minds of the foreign countries that come and invest in India. Mahuna, don't worry about that. We'll give you the benefit and we'll give you 10 there. This is what I said. This is 1023 FE. Now I'm taking you to the... Now, every practitioner has to listen to me now. It's very, very important. Charitable or religious trust, we have so many. 1023 C, 11, 12, 13. We were making law. We have already made law. I tell you what kind of a law we have. We have section. Is it complete? No. Under that we have subsection. Sir, it is complete? No. After subsection we have clause Gothaji. Is it complete? After clause we have sub-clause. Is it complete? No. After sub-clause? Nobody has read Income Tax Act. After sub-clause, sometimes there is item. And after item, there is sub-item. And after that, provided that. And after that, provided further that. And after that, provided also that. Because single proviso provided that. Second proviso provided further that. And after that, any number of proviso provided also that. 19 proviso in section 1023C provided also that, provided also that, and provided also. And still it is not complete. Explanation number one. Explanation number two. Maybe more than that also. You are looking for a full stop. The comma is after six line. What can we do? This kind of a law we have in this country. What a complicated piece of law. Ashwini ji ko maine bahut pehle, I told him, now he became ITAT member, he knows everything, whatever be. I told him, read one section every day.
said, what is this, sir? We are not able to understand. When we were doing CA, that time we also never read any act. And now we don't feel like reading any act even. I said, read one section every day. He said, okay. He read one section. He gives me a call after 4 hours. I said, what happened? Sir, 4 hours it had taken me to read one section. I said, don't worry, don't worry. He said, listen to me, sir. The last line it was written, it is not applicable from assessment year 2010-11. We don't know whether it is applicable or not applicable. You know all sections? Don't know. I said, next, whenever you read next time, please see the last line first and then only see it. Then only read it. So this kind of a law we have. We have 550 sections, not 295. 550 sections. वो तो लिखते हैं 295, but 44, 44A, 44AA, 44AB, 44AD, 44A, they are all section 44B, 44BB, 44BBA, 44BBB, 44C. These are all sections, you know. 550, we have brought down to 270. And there is no proviso in our law. Pages are 1300 now. We have brought down to 560 pages. Let's see what it comes. But we made the law simple. And it has to be simple. I'm not denying. But look here. We recommended that we have so many charitable trusts and religious trusts in India. They have been there. They are registered, no doubt. Most of them are registered. Or they are approved under 1023C. But they file a return. They give the registration number or approval number. But they do not have a certificate with them. The certificate is lost, certificate is destroyed, certificate is mutilated, torn, or something has happened. They cannot produce certificate. The AO says, you might have quoted the pen registration number, show me the certificate. He doesn't have. I told them, give us, we recommended, please let them apply once again in a simplified form. All of them should apply in a simplified form. Giving the details and give them unique ID and give them the registration without asking any question, which they agreed. But they put a rider on that law. The rider is everybody will apply now, but the earlier the registration was permanent. Now the registration will be for a period of 5 years. This is the difficulty which they have put now. You will have to apply for fresh renewal a minimum 6 months prior to the expiry date. That is, before 4.5 years, you will have to apply a fresh. Second time when you apply, that time they will take all details. This time when you apply, they will not take any detail. So they have agreed one thing. Please note, if there is a charitable trust in India or college, university, etc., who has taken approval, everyone will have to apply fresh. Whether you have been granted registration 40 years back, 20 years back, or maybe 2 months back. Nothing doing. Apply afresh in a simplified form which will come very soon. But you have to make an application within a period of 3 months from 1st of June 2020. So everyone will have to apply by 31st of August. Don't tell me later, we forgot to apply. No question of any condonation. Please apply for fresh, it's a renewal, it's a new, no, they will not ask any question. Give your number, give your trust deed, they will give you registration. If you are under approval, they'll give you approval. Done. But validity, 5 years. Date of application, 31st of August. 3 months from 1st June 2020. Is it clear, first point? Is first point clear? Everyone should apply. Whoever registered or who has got approval. Please apply by 31st August. Second now. There are many charitable trusts who have approval under 1023C and also have registration under 12AA. Many have, many. You are free to file return under either 1023C or file return under 12AA. Nobody stops you. Look here, from future, only one. Either approval or registration.
either approval or if you want registration, 12AB. If you want approval, 1023C. Decide once for all. Decide within 3 months' time and apply for fresh list. Is this clear? Now there will be no two things, one approval under 1023C, another registration under 12AA. No question. Clear? Now if you have modified your objects, which are not in consonance to what you have been doing, then within 1 month, make a fresh approval. This is already there under the law. Now look here, now most, next point. Next point, please try to understand. You are never registered. You want to start a charitable trust and you want to seek registration or approval. You want to seek? Okay. You will not be given permanent registration. You will be given only provisional registration. Earlier they were not giving registration saying that you have not started the charitable activity. You are only constructing the building. Why should we give you registration? Registration will be given to you only once you start the charitable activity. No, no. You apply, you have charitable object, apply within what time, I'll tell you, but you will get provisional registration. What is provisional? First time application, provisional registration. This will be valid for a period of 3 years. If you are not able to commence charitable activity within 3 years, then apply for renewal of that provisional registration at least 6 months before the expiry date, that is before two and a half years, apply for fresh renewal of provisional registration. But if you are able to commence your charitable activity during the period of provisional registration, then within 6 months of the commencement, surrender this and you will get permanent registration for a period of 5 years. Are you getting my point? Now when you make an application, it will be provisional registration. If your application is already pending and it has not been allotted, you will get provisional registration. How much period? 3 years. Validity, 3 years. If you don't start commercial charitable activity, you will go back and apply for a renewal at least 6 months prior to 3 years. But if you start your charitable activity during this period, within 6 months of the commencement, kindly surrender this and you get permanent registration. Now try to understand. I'm going to come to you very important point. What is the date of application for getting the registration? Last date is before the end of the previous year, relevant to the assessment year for which exemption is sought. The system is that if I want exemption from 2021 assessment year, I was supposed to apply by 31st March 20. Am I right or wrong? If I want exemption from 21-22, I'm supposed to apply by 31st March 20. No, now. You will have to apply at least 1 month before the commencement of the previous year. Please, please, 1 month before the commencement of the previous year. It is not the last day of the previous year. 1 month before the commencement of the previous year. Meaning thereby, if you want exemption from 2021, apply by 29th of February. 1 month before the commencement, 1 month before the commencement of the previous, if you want 21-22 assessment year, previous year 2021, apply by 29th February. Otherwise, you will not be given. 1 month before. Why? Because it takes time for getting the registration. Earlier, you used to apply on 31st March. You were supposed to file return on 30th September. And you used to say, we don't have a registration number. It has not been allotted. How will we be given exemption? Then we used to say applied for, it was not taking. Then you used to write a wrong number and then you used to revise that. Now no question. You will have to apply at least 1 month before the commencement of the previous year relevant to the assessment year for which exemption is being sought. Clear, sir? Clear 1 month before. 1 month before. Not end of the previous year. Clear? Now next point. Pardon me? Don't worry. It will be passed. It has not been passed. The old law, you have applied now. You will get now provisional registration. Don't worry. You will get what? Provisional. So wait. you will get provisional registration for this year. Concession may be given, the date may be extended, but future year the date will not be extended. Correct, correct. You are right, but don't worry. Are you going to apply? You have not applied earlier? Then wait for some time. You will do that. Because the form has not come. The new form will come and then you will do it. Wait, wait now. Now what is happening? This is India. People are filing a return. When the people are filing a return, they say, oh, this much tax I have not deposited. So what do you say? Please claim 80G. He claims 80G without giving donation also. Because who will check? 98% returns will go as it is. Claim 80G, claim 80C. They claim 80C also. Claim 80 TTA, 10,000 rupees. Kisko pata lagna hai? Ye to Indians hai. They keep claiming deductions without even making contribution for that. Look here now. Every charitable trust will have to prepare a complete list of contribution received by him. Every year, date will be prescribed. And that list, which contains name of the donor, address of the donor, PAN number of the donor, amount received, will be uploaded on the portal of the income tax authority. And income tax authority in turn will upload that on your registration with the income tax portal. They will upload you. You'll get the information from there. Now from 1st June, there is not going to be any 26 AS. Everything will be pre-filled and it will come to your return. Wait and watch. Now you will get deduction of 80G only when it is your name is there. It appears there in that list which has come to your portal. If name is not there, what you have given, ask that gentleman to file correction statement like 26 AS. It is like 26 AS. Now you will not be given donation at all. Deduction unless your name is there. And the charitable trust will also be put into difficulty. First, they have to apply for fresh ATG. They have to apply for fresh ATG within a period of 3 years. Secondly, ATG will be valid for? Not now, permanent, 5 years. Every 6 months prior to that, you will have to apply for fresh ATG. Look here, you have received during the year 5 crore. You have uploaded the information of 4 crore. Then you will be asked, what about this 1 crore? It is anonymous donation. An anonymous donation is liable to pay tax at the rate of 30%. Only it is exempt up to 5% of the total donation or 1 lakh, whichever is more. Because you have given the list of 4 crore and you have received 5 crore. Why the difference? Pay tax on that. So there is a cross check. You give the detail of 5 crore, you get the benefit of 5. Otherwise, cross check. So anonymous donation will be caught. The person who is claiming a deduction will be caught because if he has given the deduction. Lekin hamari country mein to bahut achhe log hain. Kaun se achhe log hain? Wo donation dekar wapas le lete hain paise. Yahan bataiye. Ya donation deke paise le lete. 50% salaried class people are claiming deduction of 80G. Khane ke paise nahi hai, donation denge hum. Wow, what kind of a people charity we are doing. What kind of a charity we are doing. And we are filing their return also. And we know that he has not paid anything. Meri fees nahi deta, donation kya dega ye? Donation, donation, donation. Ye isi country mein hai. Mere samajh mein nahi aata. Aisa kaun sa dani hai jo paise wapas le leta hai. Ye to is country mein hai. Iske liye bhi aane wala hai. Abhi ruk jaiye. Agla point. मेरे से किसी ने पूछा सर व्हाट अबाउट रिलीजियस ट्रस्ट. रिलीजियस ट्रस्ट शुड नॉट हैव 80G बट पार्टली चैरिटेबल पार्टली रिलीजियस ट्रस्ट डू हैव 80G. तो सर उनका क्या होगा. आई टोल्ड देम इफ दे रिसीव मनी अंडर चैरिटी अंडर रिलीजियस देर इज नो अनोनिमस डोनेशन. देर इज नो अनोनिमस बिकॉज भगवान को तो दान मिलता ही गुप्त का है. इज ऑलवेज गुप्त दान. You understand my point? I have earned God 1 crore rupees. Please take your share. 5%, 2%, already decided. Wo kehta tathastu. Don't worry. He has given me a share. Okay. He does it. सभी देते हैं भगवान को. किस चीज के लिए? मेरे पैसे का ध्यान रखना जो मैंने कमाए हैं. ये तेरा शेयर था, मैंने तेरे को दे दिया. चोर थी वो भी जाएगा भगवान के यार. आज मैं जा रहा हूं चोरी करने, जरा मेरा ध्यान रखना. वो कहता है तथास्तु. वो उसको शेयर दे देता है. कोई बात भगवान कुछ नहीं कहता, तथास्तु कहता है. एक सीए हमारे, वो तो मिसयूज करते हैं, क्रेडिट में भी काम कर देता है बेचारा. उसे कहते मुझे सीए पास करा दे, फिर तेरे दर्शन करने आऊंगा. वो करा देता है, फिर जाता है, जाके डुंडी में डाल आता है, 1100 रुपए तेरे पड़े थे, ले ले भगवान, मेरे को तूने पास करा दिया. बेचारा क्रेडिट में भी काम कर देता. ऐसा कोई मिलेगा? विल यू गेट ए पर्सन लाइक हिम? जो मांगो देता है और वो तथास्तु करता है. कर लो. हमारे यहाँ लेडीज, पता नहीं यहाँ नॉर्थ की तो होती हैं, वो शिव जी का 16 सोमवार का व्रत करती हैं और वो पास, वो कहते हैं मेरी शादी करा दे. वो करा देता है, कहता मुझे क्या पता, तथास्तु. भुगते की तो तू, मुझे थोड़ी भुगतना है क्या हुआ है. वो बेचारा करा देता है. ऐसा कोई मिलेगा सर? जो मांगो देता है. लेकिन कहता है कर्म तो तूने अपने करने, मेरा थोड़ी कुछ ले रहा है. मेरे लिए कोई व्हाइट ब्लैक नहीं है, मेरे लिए तू भक्त है, मैंने तेरे से ले लिया, बाकी तेरा कर्म है. तूने गलत कर्म किए तो तू भुगत, तूने अच्छे कर्म किए तो तू भुगत. क्रेडिट और डेबिट तो तेरे अकाउंट में हो रहा है, मेरे अकाउंट में तो सब क्रेडिट ही क्रेडिट है. तीसरे मैं कह रहा हूं. सो भगवान तो पूरा का पूरा दानी है, अब देता है, सब कुछ देता है. गॉड इज ग्रेट, आई एम टेलिंग यू. उससे बड़ा कोई आदमी हो ही नहीं सकता. बट यस, इट इज अप टू यू व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ए थिंग यू हैव इन माइंड. इसलिए वहां अनोनिमस डोनेशन माफ है, लेकिन लिस्ट देनी पड़ेगी. जो डिफरेंस होगा दे विल नॉट आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन बिकॉज इट इज ए रिलीजियस ट्रस्ट. क्लियर सर? सो दिस इज द लॉ विच इज कम. एनीथिंग नॉट क्लियर ऑन चैरिटी यू कैन आस्क, अदरवाइज आई एम प्रोसीडिंग फर्दर. एनीथिंग नॉट क्लियर ऑन चैरिटी. कमिंग बैक नाउ, सेक्शन 17. Sir, now income tax was passed way back in 1961. Sir, catch me. And before that also there was an income tax act. Try to listen. मैं मर गया बताकर आगे से कभी नहीं बताऊंगा डिपार्टमेंट को, क्योंकि उन्होंने बाकी फायदे हटा दिए, ये पकड़ लिया. We have a law, employer's contribution to recognized provident fund is exempt up to 12% of the salary of the employee. We have a law. How much exempt? 12%. And interest on provident fund is also exempt up to a maximum of 9.5% per annum. Clear? Now try to understand. There are so many KMPs, there are so many managing directors and rich people who are getting a salary of 1 crore per month. They are getting a salary of 6 crore per year, one getting a salary of 10 crore per year, getting a salary of 14 crore per year, and you know what Mukesh Ambani is getting. I don't want to name that. But suppose the salary is 10 crore of a year. What is 12% of that? 1 crore 20 lakh claimed as exemption by the employee, and employer is getting a deduction of that 1 crore 20 lakh employer contribution to recognized provident fund. But how much is exempt in the hands of the employee? 1 crore 20 lakh. And this is accumulated. And he gets interest also every year on that amount. And it is also exempt in hand. And when he retires, he gets tons of money without paying a single penny as tax. What kind of a planning it is being done in this country for ages. For ages, 1 crore salary, 1 lakh, 1 crore 20 lakh, exempt deduction allowed to the company. Interest on that, exempt. What is this? Now the law has been changed. Section 17, subsection 2, definition of perquisite, they have inserted clause 7 and 7A in that, saying that, still please note, three things: employer contribution to recognized provident fund, number 2, employer's contribution to superannuation fund, number 3, employer contribution to pension fund, shall be exempt only up to rupees 7,50,000. And if there is any amount excess contributed to the employer, it will be taxable in the hands of the employee as perquisites. As perquisite. How much is taxed now? 1 crore 20 lakh? Very good. 7,50,000 exempt. Pay tax on the balance 1 crore 12,50,000 in this year. Plus, whatever interest you are going to get on that 1 crore 12,50,000 shall also be taxed. This is the new law which has come. Mar gaye sare jo jyada kamate the. If you are earning more than 62,50,000 as an employee, more than 62,50, you will be into difficulty. 62,050 lakh per year multiplied by 12% is 7,50,000. Maximum deduction exemption 750. तो जितने बड़े बड़े के एम पी बेंगलोर में तो बहुत हैं, am I right? जिनको बहुत सैलरी मिलती है, मारेंगे मुझे ये क्या करवा दिया आपने. एवरी वन इज अफेक्टेड बिकॉज दे विल नाउ हैव टू पे टैक्स ऑन द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन एक्सीडिंग रुपीज 7,50,000 पर ईयर. क्लियर? क्लियर. लेकिन हमने बहुत कुछ कहा था. हमने कहा था लॉ को सिंप्लीफाई कर दीजिए. क्या सिंप्लीफिकेशन किया, जरा सुनिए. अब मैं क्रिटिसाइज करने जा रहा हूं, सुनिए. देयर इज नो चेंज इन द रेट्स ऑफ इनकम टैक्स. डिड दे चेंज एनीथिंग? नो चेंज इन द रेट्स ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, सेम. बट दे हैव ब्रॉट नाउ वन सेक्शन कॉल्ड 115 BAC. लैंग्वेज सुनना. Not withstanding anything contained under any other provisions of the Income Tax Act. एक ही बारे में पूरा इनकम टैक्स खत्म कर दिया. An individual or HUF can opt to pay tax at the following rates, so provided the condition mentioned under Section 115 BAC, subsection 2 are satisfied. What did they say? Notwithstanding what is given under any other provision, if you are an individual or you are HUF, you can opt. Choice is yours. You can opt to pay tax at the following rate, provided those conditions are satisfied. What is the rate? On the first 2,50,000, nil. Next 2,50,000, 5%. Next 2,50,000, 10%. Next 2,50,000, 15%. Next 2,50,000, 20%. Next 2,50,000, 25%. And balance 30. What simple way? Add 250, add 5%. What a simple thing. Six rates. Earlier there were only three rates. First 250, nil. Next 250, 5. Next 250, 10. Next 250, 15. Next 250, 20. Next 250, 25. And 30. What a great. But wait. If you follow this, then if you are a salaried employee, that leave travel concession which you used to get for two journeys in a block of 4 years, you will not get the exemption. We used to take our family once in 2 years. Chaliye. Ticket was given by the employer and money was spent by us, but now you will not be able to take it. Number two, house rent allowance, which is exempt under 1013A to a certain amount, will not be exempt in your hand. What kind of law is this? Number three, those allowances which are exempt under 1014, like uniform allowance, like research allowance, like helper allowance, will not be allowed to you. Children education allowance, hostel expenditure allowance will not be allowed to you. Okay, sir. Next, standard deduction of 50,000 will also not be allowed to you. Next, tax on employment, professional tax, will also be not allowed to you. Next, if you have borrowed money for construction of your house or purchase of your house and you were eligible for a deduction of interest subject to maximum of rupees 2 lakh, will not be allowed to you. If you borrow money and give the house on rent, and if the rent is less than the interest, that interest which is excess, loss, will not be allowed to be set up from any other head of income or not be allowed to be carried for. Nothing will happen. You want ATC? Not allowed. ATCCC? Not allowed. ATCCD? Not allowed. Medical? Not allowed. Borrowed money for children education? Not allowed. Will not be allowed anything. ATTTA 10,000, that too will not be allowed. Kya milega? Kuch nahi milega. Sirf tax dijiye aur jaan chhuda lijiye aur yes rate mein dijiye. Kya baatein kar rahe hain aap? What kind of a law is this? No standard deduction, no ATC, no ATD, no ATE, अरे लुक हियर, वी इंडियंस, इवन ऑल ऑफ यू हैव सेव्ड मनी फॉर योर फ्यूचर एंड क्लेम्ड डिडक्शन अंडर 80C. Whether it was difficult or whatever, maybe everybody tried to save money, and he has built a little amount capital for himself. He has built capital for himself for his future. We have no unemployment thing, and we have also insured ourselves against the medical, even for our parents, and getting a reduction under 80D. That also will go. We have educated our children by borrowing money. He is doing some course, a postgraduate course or a graduate course, or he's gone abroad. We never had money, but we have children. We wanted to make money for that. We told them, look here, wait, we will educate you. We'll borrow. We will do whatever we like, but we will educate you, because we were getting a deduction of interest also under 80E. We constructed house long back, or we purchased flat. Why did we purchase? At that time, the flat cost maybe 30 lakh, 25 lakh, but we borrowed money. We were allowed interest, so we borrowed it and paid all the installment. Now the flat cost maybe 6 crore. At that time it was 30 lakh about 20 years back. We have made something out of the savings. This country needs saving. You want creation of wealth. How will the wealth be created if you are not allowed to give any deduction on that? Kaun karega? Sir, wo apne aap kare jo karna chahta hai. हम तो उसको कहेंगे छुट्टी कर, जो पैसे दे और जे तू इंजॉय कर. वह कहाँ इन्वेस्ट करेगा? वो कर लेगा बैंक में. मैं कहा, वो कहेगा 6% मिलता है बैंक में. नहीं नहीं, मैं तो शेयर में करूँगा. मैं करके देख ले, हमने भी करा था, क्या हालत है हमारी. मैं तो डेरिवेटिव में करूँगा, लोगों ने बड़ा कमाया है. अरे जुआ खेलेगा और कुछ नहीं करेगा. क्या बात कर रहे हैं यार. हम लोगों ने सेविंग करी है, सबने करी है, और हिम्मत करी अपने बच्चों को पालने के लिए. 80D किया, मेडिकल किया. अरे यार, आप क्या चाहते हो? What do you want in this country? There is no any. ये क्या अमेरिका है? 16 साल के बाद बच्चा छोड़ देता है बाप को. It's not अमेरिका. वहां अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट है, वहां सोशल सिक्योरिटी है. What is here? अभी हम तो पहले ही अपने बच्चों से डरते हैं. आप बता दें, एक आदमी यहां पर, हम तो सैंडविच सोसाइटी हैं. मैं अपने पेरेंट्स से भी डरता था और अपने बच्चों से भी डरता हूं. Am I right or wrong? ऐसा कोई खड़ा होकर बता दे, मैं अपने बच्चों से नहीं डरता. एक बता दे हिम्मत करके, खड़ा तो हो जाए. Am I right, sir? हम अपने बच्चों से भी डरते हैं, अपने माँ बाप से भी डरते थे. वो पता क्या कहता है, मैंने शादी नहीं करानी. मैं करा ले ना, लिव इन रिलेशनशिप में रहूंगा पहले. अच्छा भाई, कर ले भाई. हमारे जमाने में तो था नहीं ऐसा कुछ. फिर क्या कहता है, करा लूंगा अगर आप फोर्स करते हो. 10 साल बाद कहता है, लेकिन बच्चे पैदा नहीं करूंगा. तो मैंने कहा, क्यों नहीं करेगा यार जनरेशन? ना ना ना, मैं नहीं करता. फिर उसको बड़ी जबरदस्ती कहते हैं, कर ले. कंडीशन लगाता है, एक ही करूंगा. मैं कह रहा, हमारे यहां तो 10-10 हो जाते थे, फर्क नहीं पड़ता था. तू क्या चाहता है? नहीं नहीं, एक ही करूंगा. भैया, उसको पालेगा कैसे ये तो बता दे. क्यों, तू तो खा पी के मौज करेगा. टैक्स दे के कहेगा, मेरे को तो जिमिंग करनी नहीं, मेरे को क्या करने की जरूरत है. अरे करेगा नहीं तो बच्चों को कैसे पालेगा, उसको पढ़ाई कैसे कराएगा? वो अपने आप करेगा, मुझे क्या लेना देना. ये कौन सा लॉ है यार? हम लोगों ने पैसा बनाया इस कंट्री में, पैसा सेविंग से बना इस कंट्री से. पैसा हाउसेस बने तो लोन मिला और उसकी वजह से हमने पैसे बनाए. इस कंट्री में हमने अपना मेडिकल कराया, वो तो बनाया. वो तो अपने बाप को क्या कहेगा, तेरा मेडिकल नहीं कराऊंगा क्योंकि मुझे डिडक्शन तो मिलनी नहीं है. मैं क्यों कराऊं, अपने आप करा ले तू, कराना है. क्या होने जा रहा है इस कंट्री में यार? व्हाट इज दिस कंट्री वी आर गोइंग टू डू? हमने किया था कि सिंप्लीफाई करो, लेकिन हमने कहा था सारे अलाउंसेस लाकर स्टैंडर्ड डिडक्शन को 50 से 80 कर दो, हटा दो. चलो 80 कर दो, सेकंड 80C जरूर रखना, रादर उसको 1.5 का 2 भी कर सकते हैं, और 80D जरूर देना. 80D इज मेडिकल. इतना तो कर देते हैं. ये क्या लॉ बनाया मोदी जी, मैंने तो समझ में नहीं आया. सिंप्लीफाई कर रहे. What is this simplification, यार? आप तो मरवा देंगे कंट्री को, ये नहीं चलेगा. अरे जिसकी सैलरी 50,000 रुपीज है ना, वो भी नहीं जाएगा. कितना मिला? 6 लाख. प्लानिंग कर नहीं सकता तो 6 पे टैक्स देना पड़ेगा. अभी क्या करता है, 6 लाख में 1 लाख का डिडक्शन ले लेता है. 50,000 रुपया स्टैंडर्ड डिडक्शन, कोई मेडिकल, कोई 80C, और 5 से नीचे आ जाता है. कोई टैक्स नहीं देता, सात वाला भी नहीं देता, डेढ़ लाख कर लेता उधर, उधर पचास मिलता है वो भी नहीं देता, नौ लाख वाला भी नहीं देता, फ्लैट खरीद लेता है दो लाख, वहां भी डिडक्शन क्लेम कर, वो कहाँ जाएगा? वो कर ही नहीं सकता, वो कहता मुझे नहीं जाना है, मैं तो वही पुराने में जाऊंगा। और फिर देखिए सीनियर सिटीजन को तीन लाख का एग्जेम्पशन मिलता था, वेरी सीनियर सिटीजन को पांच लाख का मिलता था, या ढाई लाख ही मिलेगा, ये कौन सा तरीका है? गधे घोड़े बराबर, ये क्या है? ढाई का ही एग्जेम्पशन है, कोई सीनियर सिटीजन नहीं, कोई कुछ नहीं, अरे क्या चाहते हो? 80D भी नहीं। अरे यार दिस इज नॉट डन, कोई नहीं जाएगा, कोई नहीं जाएगा उधर, जा सकता ही नहीं है, चोर जाएंगे 80 जो 44AD में है, यहां पर ब्यूटी पार्लर ज्यादा खुला करेंगे आगे से, समझ में आया मैंने क्या? उनको डिडक्शन थोड़ी लेनी होती है, उनको तो ब्लैक का व्हाइट करना होता है, दिखा देंगे। व्हाट आर यू डूइंग? व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ लॉ इज दिस दैट यू आर नॉट अलाउड टू सेव एनीथिंग, यू आर नॉट अलाउड टू कंस्ट्रक्ट, यू आर नॉट अलाउड दिस थिंग, अरे व्हाट आर यू अलाउड? नथिंग, एंजॉय योर लाइफ। कंजम्पशन बढ़ जाएगी, मैं कहा बढ़ेगी तब देखूंगा क्या होगी। कोई नहीं जाएगा सर, एक आदमी यहां से बताओ वो जाएगा, होगा कोई एक आध आदमी जिसके पास फंड्स नहीं है जोड़ने के, वो शायद चला जाए। और टैक्स तो हम तो इनकम तो हम अपने हिसाब से भरते हैं, वो आपके हिसाब से थोड़ी भरते हैं, वो तो सैलरी वाला भरता है अपने हिसाब, उसको मजबूरी है, आप नहीं करना चाहिए। दिस इज नॉट डन, टाइम हो गया होगा, टाइम इज अप। पहले तो मुझे मिला करता था 10 मिनट हैं, हाँ 5 मिनट हैं, और एक दिन मेरी पीछे वाइफ बैठी हुई थी, चेयरमैन यहाँ बैठा था, तो उसने लिख के भेजा पर्ची पे KISS। तो चेयरमैन कहता है इस एज में भी आपकी वाइफ इतना प्यार करती है? मैं कह नहीं, इसमें लिखा कीप इट शॉर्ट स्टूपिड, ये तो वो भी नहीं है, मैंने कहा जाओ छोड़ दो, अब हमें कुछ नहीं चाहिए, गिव मी 5 मिनट्स, सब इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, 5 मिनट्स, कैन आई टेक योर 5 मिनट्स? 5 मिनट्स। देयर इज अ लिबरलाइज स्कीम वेयर यू कैन ट्रांसफर $2,50,000 एवरी ईयर टू एनी कंट्री आउटसाइड इंडिया। अरे क्या तरीका है? नाउ यू ट्रांसफर द मनी, 5% TCS विल बी कलेक्टेड। आई सेड व्हाट इज दिस, यू ऑलरेडी हैव 15CA, विदाउट 15CA नो वी आर मॉनिटरिंग। आई सेड वेट, क्यों हो रहा है? माई चाइल्ड इज स्टडिंग अब्रॉड, आई हैव टू सेंड मनी देयर, मिनिमम मनी टू बी सेंट इज 1 crore, आई माइट हैव टेकन लोन, आई माइट हैव बोरोड, और आई माइट हैव डन समथिंग, सोल्ड एनीथिंग, नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू सेंड, यू विल से फर्स्ट डिपॉजिट 5 lakh एज वॉट TCS, देन ओनली यू कैन। समबडी इज गोइंग फॉर अ ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कैंसर, ही डजंट हैव मनी, नाउ ही वॉन्ट्स टू टेक द मनी देयर, यू विल से 5%। आई सेड यू बाई अ मर्सिडीज कार, TCS इज 1%, बट यू गो फॉर टेस्ट अब्रॉड, यू पे 5%। वॉट इज दिस लॉ? 10 lakh के ऊपर 5% है, 1% है कार का, या 5% है? मॉनिटरिंग करना है। मैं कहा मॉनिटरिंग करिए, 0.5% पे भी मॉनिटरिंग हो जाती है, 0.25% पे भी मॉनिटरिंग हो जाती है, ये 5% क्यों कर रहे हैं? ओ नहीं नहीं नहीं, अरे सर कि वो जो कई लोग हैं जो उनका पैन नंबर नहीं है वो भेज रहे हैं। मैं कहा उनका कर दो ज्यादा, बाकियों को क्यों कर रहे हो 5%? इट्स अ वेरी बिग अमाउंट TCS। आई डोंट फेल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ए लॉ इज मेड। मुझे पता किसने बनाया, मैं कुछ कह नहीं सकता, है तो हमारी फटर्निटी का ही, लेकिन है डिपार्टमेंट में, बड़ा बेहद करता है सर, आप जानते हैं। फिर फॉरेन ट्रिप पे जा रहे हो 5%, मुझे वो प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, क्योंकि लोग पता नहीं बैंक को क्या करने जाते हैं, अब तो 5% देना ही पड़ेगा ना, कोई बात नहीं, वो हैव नो प्रॉब्लम। नाउ व्हाट यू आर सेइंग दैट यू आर टर्न ओवर ऑफ द प्रीसीडिंग प्रीवियस इज 10 crore एंड यू हैव रिसीव्ड दिस ईयर 50 lakh और मोर सम फ्रॉम समबडी, कलेक्ट 0.1%। अरे क्वेश्चन इज ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस, वो कह रहा था सीज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस, ये ईज कहां से हो गया? कंप्लायंस बढ़ा रहे हैं आप, कंप्लायंस। हमने एक कहा था, लास्ट बता रहा हूं, कि डिविडेंड को शिफ्ट कर दो ओल्ड सिस्टम, ये हमने ही करा है, हमने बोला था, कारण बताता हूं क्या है। आई सेड लेट अस शिफ्ट टू द क्लासिकल सिस्टम, बिकॉज अर्लियर देयर वॉज नो मॉनिटरिंग, नाउ द पेमेंट ऑफ डिविडेंड इज ऑल गिवन बाई चेक और सॉरी अकाउंट पे सॉरी ऑनलाइन, सो वेर इज द प्रॉब्लम? मान गया हमारी बात, हमने क्या क्या कारण है, कुछ एडवांटेजेस हैं। वन हुज इन्वेस्टर हुज रेट ऑफ टैक्स इज 5% विल पे 5% इंस्टेड ऑफ 20% विच इज एट प्रेजेंट। वन हुज इन द ब्रैकेट ऑफ 10 विल पे 10, ब्रैकेट ऑफ 15 विल पे 15, ब्रैकेट ऑफ 20 विल पे 20, बट आई विल बी अफेक्टेड I'm in the bracket of 30 plus surcharge plus this. Earlier at 20, my amount is less than 10 lakh. If it is more than 10 lakh, I was paying on 10 lakh also. I will have to pay more because surcharge plus odd 15% extra I'll pay. I told them, bring standard reduction of 20% so that the rate from 30% will come down to 24%. We'll bear that, but the advantage is different. One advantage of having this is Section 14A gone. The litigation, the amount of litigation you have under Section 14A, you all know that. Exempt income, disallow expenses, all. Now there will be no problem of 14A, actually it's for dividend. And secondly, foreign institutional investors, foreign companies, FPIs, were hesitant in investing in India in shares. Why? They say, we are non-resident. We are investing here. The domestic company pays tax here, given the dividend. Now, when we receive dividend, it is exempt in our hand. Am I right? Since it is exempt, we have to pay tax in our foreign country. Income which accrue or rise outside their country is taxable there. There are two taxes. One paid by the domestic company, 20% here. One paid, going to be paid by us in the foreign country because we have earned income from a country, from foreign country. So we are doubly taxed. This is not done. Hamein toh mushkil padti hai. If you shift it to us, to the, then we will get the credit of the tax paid in India in that foreign country. And secondly, due to treaty, the maximum dividend tax is 10%. 10%. So they are benefited. All foreign companies will invest in shares of Indian company, will pay dividend tax only 10%. And that tax which they have paid in India, they will get credit also in their country. Don't you think it is a good proposal? We were not interested in it. We were interested to attract foreign capital in this country so that they come to India, they should not be put to harassment of paying double tax here also and there also. They will be paying tax as per treaty in this country is only 10%. And whatever they pay here, they'll get exemption in that country. So this is the reason why we brought that shift the dividend tax in the hands of the recipient and not in the hands of the company. There are so many others, but they throw me out. That's why thank you very much for the patient hearing. Thank you.